What do you call two metalheads headbanging? 6669. That's a joke I made up, I'm pretty sure. I'm not in the most energetic, happy, entertaining mood today, so I thought great time to film a video. I know that you guys will cheer me up. Clearly, you all love and care for me deeply. My teenage children going through a rebellious phase, and like, you can hate me all you want, but I'm your mom. Now I'm gonna show you an album from one of my all-time favorite bands, Carpathian Forest. This album is actually a compilation. This band is from Norway. Just really, really awesome stuff. Not atmospheric black metal, as I've been showing you, but more pure black metal. So it opens like this. Has all the lyrics. So you can sing along. And these discs are really pretty too. So, if you're like me, you're a hardcore, real badass metalhead, right? Clearly. But what happens if you're not actually very hardcore? You're actually a pussy ass bitch. I don't actually want to get in trouble. Well, there are small ways, small tiny ways that you can live on the edge. Drinking coffee that has been sitting there all day in the coffee pot. You may get a disease from that. That's exciting. That's living on the edge. Now, I would never do something as preposterous as jaywalking, for example. But what you can do, you ever sit on the toilet and balance your phone on your leg? It might fall into the toilet. It might not. What else is living on the edge phone-wise? I don't have a password on my phone. And I have all my personal information and naked pictures on there. Free game for anybody who finds my phone. I like to give strangers my address. People who want to give me stuff, shirts to promote their band or whatever the fuck. Yeah, I'll give them my address. I don't care. They might come and kill me. That's the excitement of it. I also like to play tab roulette, browser tab roulette. I like to have the max number of tabs open, so many that you can't even see the icon, and then have other people try to navigate my laptop. That's fun for me because it always happens where they click on a porn tab. They'll start closing other tabs, and then tabs get longer, and then you can see that they're all porn sites, and people are like, why are you keeping all these porn tabs open? And I say, I like to live on the edge. Or I just tell them I like to keep all my porn tabs open so I remember all the videos that I want to watch next time. Because what I like to do is like line up my videos so I don't have to like keep searching for them like mid fucking jack off, you know what I mean? Now that you know my whole process of porn watching, then you should also know that I also have porn videos of myself literally just on my desktop. And I just realized this now that I have that. So maybe I should be a little more careful with that. But no, because it helps me feel dangerous. You know where the best place to live dangerously is? Yeah, you guessed it, the kitchen. If you can't handle the heat, get out of the kitchen. Just by that saying alone, you can tell the kitchen can be a dangerous, dangerous place. A few things I like to do. First of all, cooking naked, because there's always a possibility of burning your nipples, which has happened to me. Because leading to my next point, I don't use oven mitts or a strainer. I use my hands or I use my sleeves. So what I do is like with the boiling pot of pasta, I just take it and I flip it over the sink so that the water drains out. There's always a possibility that all the noodles will fall out, which has happened to me before. And sometimes if I'm feeling, you know, crafty, I'll actually go and clean all the noodles and then just eat them, even though my sink is full of dirty dishes. It's fine. It adds more flavor, you know, flavor from past meals that I've eaten. And in doing that, I've literally burnt, like, just my nipple before. And that was pretty awesome because I'm into that. Also, cooking everything on high. Like, I go straight to the fucking max. Go high and get high. Only use knives. I only use knives for, I cut, chop, choppity, chop the vegetables with the knife. Then I stir, stirity, stir with that knife. Then that same knife I use to eat sometimes. And knives are really, really your best friend. You're not gonna find a better friend than a knife. The knife can't stab you in the back because you're the one holding it. So those are my tips on how to live on the edge, but don't stand on the edge because that's dangerous. I always advocate not standing near the edge. Let me know what you do to feel edgy and dangerous. I'm so edgy, I cut myself every time I touch myself. So listen to Bloodlust and Perversion while masturbating with a knife. Have a dangerous day. Bye.